Greetings and welcome to Astronomy 104 at HAC. One of the things that has given students trouble at times in the class is the idea of the distance modulus in astronomy and doing calculations with that. So I'm going to take a few minutes here and go over a couple of examples about the distance modulus and using the equation that is given here to show how we can go actually use this to go ahead and do calculations and determine the distances to stars. Now, first, to determine what the distance modulus is, I want to look at a couple of examples. We're going to talk about a couple different cases. And the first is, what happens if the two magnitudes are equal? But first, we have to go back and define what the magnitudes are. And lowercase m is the apparent magnitude. That is how bright something appears to be. Capital M is the absolute magnitude. That's how bright something truly is. That's a true measure of its brightness. If we know those two numbers for any given star, then we can determine its distance directly from this equation. So, let's look at our first example here. And that is, what happens if the two magnitudes are equal to each other? So if the magnitudes are equal, then when we subtract, then m minus m is equal to 0. And that means that the star is just as bright as it should be. It appears as bright as it should be for our standard distance. So that means the star is at the standard distance that we determined. And for astronomers, that standard distance is 10 parsecs. And that is where a star with a distance modulus of 0 would be. So that would be 10 parsecs. So if the distance modulus, and the distance modulus itself is actually just this part of the equation, we use m minus m, this part is what we call the distance modulus. So that is our that's what we use to determine. And that tells us the distance. Right there, that portion of it. Now, so if that distance modulus is equal to 0, we are at the standard distance, and the standard distance is defined in astronomy to be 10 parsecs, or about 32 light years away. Now, what about some other cases? What happens if the two magnitudes are not the same? As I said, that's the easiest case. What happens if the apparent magnitude is much greater than the absolute magnitude? What does that mean? Now, we have to remember that distances, that magnitudes are backwards. So when we say that m is greater, that means that this star is fainter than it should be. It is fainter than it would be if it were located at 10 parsecs. Therefore, it is more distant. It is further away than 10 parsecs. How much further away? Depends on the exact numbers. We're going to go on to calculations of those in just a couple of minutes. So this star is fainter than it should be. And in the last case, we have what is if m is less than capital M. So this star is actually, now again, is less than. That means that this is brighter than it truly should be. And that means that it is closer than 10 parsecs. So this would be a positive value of the distance modulus. If it's positive, it's far away. If it's negative, it is very close. Again, not necessarily what you would expect, because we tend to look for positive numbers, you know, not exactly the way you'd necessarily think of it, but the positive numbers are more distant, further away, and the negative numbers are closer. Now let's do a couple of example calculations here. Let's do the simple example. Let's say the two magnitudes are exactly the same. So what do? We put our numbers into the equation here. So little m here, this is 0, capital M, and that's 0. So 0 minus 0 is equal to 5 times the logarithm of the distance divided by 10. 0 minus 0 is 0, so that's easy. 5 log of distance over 10. Now, 0 divided by 5 is going to be 0. We like this one. Works out nice and simple, right? So 0 is equal to the logarithm of d over 10. Now, astronomers still like to use logarithms. That's the way our magnitude scale works. So to get rid of this, we have to use the inverse log function. And that would be inverse log on a scientific calculator. Or it might be seen as 10 to the x power. So in this case, our x is 0, and 10 to the 0th power is 1. So 1 is equal to d divided by 10, or d is equal to 10 parsecs. Our units in this are always parsecs. So that's exactly what we said in the first case. If the two magnitudes are exactly equal, then the distance is 10 parsecs. What if they're not exactly equal? We'll just do a couple examples with that. So let's look at little m being 2.5 and big M being 7.5. Now, again, let's go back to our first page and think about this. That means that this star is brighter than it should be. So it is brighter, meaning that our calculation should show that it is closer than 10 parsecs. So as a quick check there, when we're done, we should get something closer than 10 parsecs. Let's see if we do. So let's put our numbers into the equation. 2.5 minus 7.5 equals 5 times the logarithm of d divided by 10. 2.5 minus 7.5 is going to be minus negative 5. So negative 5 is equal to 5 log, again, of d over 10. Let's divide. Negative 5 divided by 5 is negative 1 equals logarithm of d over 10. Now, if we do inverse log, that's 10 to the minus 1 power, which is 0.1. So when we do inverse log, we're going to end up with 0.1 equals d over 10, or d equals 10 times 0.1, d is equal to 1 parsec. Does that check? Does that check with what we said here? We got an answer of 1 parsec. And is that the same? Yes, it is closer than 10 parsecs. At least we have a check there saying we didn't do something completely wrong. It is closer than 10 parsecs as we predicted. So there's one more. Now let's do a slightly more difficult example. Let's look at the opposite situation. And that would be, what if we have an apparent magnitude that is much less than the absolute magnitude? Much less in terms of fainter. So this star is fainter than it should be if it were at the standard distance. So it means it's going to be further away. It is going to be more distant than it should be. So let's put our numbers in. Little m here is 15.32 and capital M is 6.76. Now let's put our numbers in and we're going to do the calculation. Now. Okay. So we do our calculation and we say what? We're going to say 15.32 minus 6.76. That's just putting our numbers in here for little m and big M is equal to 5 times the logarithm of d over 10. Let's subtract 15.32 and take away 6.76. We're going to get 8.56 is equal to 5 times the logarithm of d over 10. Now we have to divide 8.56. We have to divide by 5. Divide both sides by 5. That will cancel there. 8.56 divided by 5 is 1.71 is equal to the logarithm of d divided by 10. Now we have to do 10 to the 1.71 power. That's our inverse logarithm. That's how we find to get rid of the log function. And if you do that, put that into your calculator, into the scientific calculator, you'll get that 51.3 is equal to d divided by 10, or d is equal to 513 parsecs. Did we get it right? Well, let's look again. We said it was going to be further away than 10 parsecs. Is this further away than 10 parsecs? Yes, it's 513 parsecs. So that's a good check. Again, doesn't guarantee that we got exactly the right answer, but it lets you know that you're at least on the right track. So I hope that these examples have helped. I know we have some of this on a homework assignment, and I wanted to give you a few examples that I've worked through that you can go back and review. So hopefully that works, helps everybody. Have a great day, and I will see you in class.